All right, guys, we are happy as always. It is Monday afternoon to have Danielle Shay, VP of Options with Simpler Trading. And Mr. Luke is in the building once again.
That's right,
he is. To help us out on a busy, busy week. Great to have you both. I mean, there's a ton to talk about, so let's jump right into it. CPI coming tomorrow. We get PPI this week. Give me your thoughts here. I mean, we get this emergency meeting from the Fed today. The overall market doesn't seem to care too much. Back to the upside, as Sean was mentioning when we came on at 2 o'clock, you know, if there's an indication even that the Fed's going to pause here and maybe a quarter point is the worst case scenario coming up in a couple of weeks, this is why, or a good indication as to why, tech is rallying today.
Well, you know what, Brendan? I think that they're going to have to pause because when you're looking at what happened last week, I mean, the Fed was focused on inflation, right? And they were trying to battle inflation, but we knew that with the aggressive stance they were taking, they were very likely to break something. And look what they did. They broke the banks. So I think they're going to have to pause. I don't think that they have another choice because I think that bank stress is going to be more important than inflation at this point. And so, yes, I mean, that opens up the market for tech to rally.
Yeah, it's a very tough spot, obviously, you know, trying to weigh those two catalysts as to which direction you want to go to. I mean, we've seen some monster names in the news for all the wrong reasons over the past couple of days. Signature Bank, obviously a very well-known, well-established bank, gets taken over by New York State officials on the weekend. SVB, well discussed on this show. Going back to last Thursday and Friday as well. I want to focus on this WAL. Maybe give me your thoughts before we do. Give me your thoughts here on the entire group. From an option standpoint, how do you approach something like this? Is there, you know, pieces to be picked up at some point?
Well, you know, part of the problem is it's really hard to get into it now. You know, honestly, I was kicking myself over the weekend because I was thinking, oh my gosh, this was literally the most obvious short, you know, in the regional banks. And I mean, at this point, they've been crushed so badly that I really don't know how you could get in it at this point to the short side. Because I mean, you'd be buying pretty much the dead lows. Obviously, some of these banks, if they continue to fail, then yeah, you could still short them. But honestly, I don't think we can do anything here. We might be able to start buying them once they bounce. But I still think that there's a lot of uncertainty. And so I wouldn't want to do it until we can really start to see some buyers come in. And then at that point, you may be able to at least trade a retracement, maybe 50% retracement in some of these regional banks. To the upside if they start ripping.
And that was kind of where I was going with that, in the sense that the CEO comes out for this WAL today and says, you know, everything's fine, financials are fine. He's such a great baby. Financials are fine.
Don't jinx it.
I'm sure they have their moments, right? The deposit insurance is covering more than 50% at this point, so you know, there's going to be a few that survive here. So at some point, maybe this move to the downside is overdone. As you said, you know, we need to see some buyers. We need to see a bit of a bounce come into play first before you get too excited about it. But, you know, what does that time frame look like from an option standpoint if you were going to put on a position here?
So if I was going to put on a position, I would go out at least 3 to 4 weeks, and I would do it as a swing trade. So I would go out about 3 to 4 weeks, probably April monthly expiration. You could even go out into May monthly expiration. And with a play like that, you could actually do Delta 50 or Delta 30 out of the money options, which would mean that they're pretty cheap. Really, the only good time to buy out of the money options is when you have an extreme move like this. And so, you know, I think that that's definitely possible when we start going back up to the upside. But I think that my biggest concern right now is that, I mean, if you have your money in a regional bank, would you want to keep it there? I wouldn't. Thankfully, I use JP Morgan Chase. But I mean, if it were me and I had my money in any of these regional banks, I would be out of there. So I just think that this is going to, you know, show continued pressure in this sector.
Yeah, no, it's a great point. And I mean, there was all kinds of video and all kinds of pictures over the weekend of long lines, you know, of people doing whatever they need to on a Saturday, even just to try and pull some money out of their accounts. On that note, is there maybe one or two that we can look to as far as, if you haven't got into it that far, that's fine, but is there one or two that you've been looking at for that type of idea?
No, and you know why? Is because with what's going on right now, it is just, it's incredibly hard to know on the back end without doing the in-depth macro, you know, overall analysis, which one it would be. And so for that reason, normally what I like to do is I like to stick with the ETF. So you can trade the KRE. That is going to carry a lot less risk. And, you know, I think that it'll be a much better average than trying to pick an individual name. Because, I mean, just even the way that those two blew up last week, I mean, it happened so quickly. And it was one of those things that just really couldn't have been predicted. So I think it's safer to stick with the ETF.
Fair. On that note, let's talk more positively, shall we? Because as I was saying when we came on here, I mean, there's a 25%, I think it was right now, chance that they do nothing at the next Fed meeting coming up here in 9 days after all of this has come to fruition over the past couple of days. And that has tech, Apple, Microsoft, the big ones, obviously, back to the upside today. Great day for Microsoft, 3.5%. Apple's 2.25% right now. Even Tesla trying to get up, you know, around that 1% to the upside. Tell me about your thoughts here going into not only tomorrow, but ahead of what's to come next week when it comes to big tech.
So usually the mega cap tech stocks are the ones that I look to trade first when the market starts shifting back up to the upside, which it's doing right now. And I mean, Microsoft is absolutely one of my favorites. So, I mean, I think trading Microsoft back up to 265, 270 makes sense as long as the momentum continues higher. I think trading Apple back up to 157 makes sense as well. And then what I would do after that is I want to watch those key areas of resistance, because Microsoft and Apple are the market leading stocks. And so if they end up breaking, you know, if Apple can break up to 160, then I mean, that would be a major bullish sign for the rest of the NASDAQ. If Microsoft could break up above 275, I mean, I would love to see that. And then I could start getting even more, you know, long and bullish on the market. But again, I want to reiterate the fact that it's going to largely depend on what happens with the Fed, and especially tomorrow.
Yeah, if we get that, you know, hotter than expected number as we did last time, it's going to be, I mean, all of this could change once again in 24 hours time. I know you have your hands full. We appreciate you jumping on anyways, as always. Great information, great ideas, as always. He is. Mr. Luke, what would his choice be?
I think he likes Tesla.
Obviously.
Like
son, like mother. Great stuff. Danielle Shay is VP of Options over at Simpler Trading. Thank you so much.
Thank you.